Hi, in this video we are going to talk about k-means clustering. K-means is an unsupervised classification technique that we can use to partition a dataset into k distinct groups. The goal is that observations within a same cluster or group are as similar as possible, while observations in different groups are as dissimilar as possible. There are several algorithms that have been proposed for k-means clustering. In this book, An Introduction to Statistical Learning with Applications in R, we can find one of the algorithms. Here, for example, the first step would be to assign a number from 1 to k randomly to each of the observations and then calculate the cluster centroid, which would be a vector with the average for the variables for all the observations in each of the clusters, and then each observation would be assigned to the closest centroid. These two steps would be repeated until the cluster assignments stop changing or until a given number of iterations. In other algorithms, this step may be different, so instead of assigning a number from 1 to k to each of the observations, then k observations may be selected randomly, and then those observations will be assigned as the centroids. In R, we can calculate the k-means clustering with the k-means function. I'm going to do an example here, and I'm going to use the wine dataset. In this dataset, we have information about several wine brands. We have data about our rating, price, alcohol, residual sugar, sulfates, and pH. And we have some categorical variables that I'm going to remove here. So I'm going to remove them, and then I'm going to standardize the continuous variables. This step is important to avoid that variables with a larger range of values have more influence on the results than variables with a shorter range of values. So what we do here is that we center the data around the mean, and then we divide by the standard deviations of each variable, so then each variable will have standard deviations as units. Okay, let's run this code, and then let's work with the k-means function. In this function, we are going to need to enter first the data set, then we enter the number of centers or clusters that we want to create. So this is defined by the user. We can ask for 2, 3, 10 or more clusters. Other arguments here, for example, are the maximum number of iterations. We can set this, for example, to 100, or we could use this nStart argument to define the number of random sets that should be created. So R will create a given number of random sets, and at the end we'll keep the set that produces the best results. So, okay, let's run this code. And let's see the output here. So we are running k-means clustering with three clusters. Here we see the number of observations in each of the clusters. Then we see this table with the cluster centroids. So each of the rows here in this table is one cluster, and this will be the corresponding centroid. So this will be the average value for each of the variables in the observations in that cluster. So for example, we can see that if we examine, let's say, the rating variable, then the average would be 0 for this first cluster, then the average for rating variable in the second cluster would be close to 1, while the average for this same variable in cluster 3 would be negative and around 0.8. Then we can take a look at this clustering vector. This is a vector that shows to which cluster each observation in the dataset will be assigned. So let's say that here we have our wine dataset, and then this means that the first observation in the dataset will be assigned to cluster 2. So this first observation will be assigned to cluster 2, and then observations 2 and 3 will be assigned to cluster 3, and so on. We can also see here the within cluster sum of squares. This can be used, for example, for defining the best value for k. So we will try to minimize the total within sum of squares. In our script, we could try, for example, a different value for k or the number of clusters, let's say this, and then we would get slightly different results for clusters, and then the clustering vector, and then the within cluster sum of squares. So we could try different values for k, we could use a for loop, and then let's say evaluate values for k between 2 and 10 or more. We could do that manually, or we could use some packages that provide that functionality. For example, this factor extra package This can help us to evaluate the this case means clustering algorithm for different values of k. There are different methods for selecting the best value for k. Here, for example, we have these methods, the within sum of squares, the average silhouette width, or the gap statistic. So if we try with the first method, WSS, we get this chart. So we got the number of clusters in the x-axis and the total within sum of squares in the y-axis. So for example, when we run this algorithm for k equal to 3, then we got this within cluster sum of squares, which the total value will be around 400, which is the value that we see here for 3. To define the optimal number of clusters, we would use the elbow rule or knee rule. So we would try to find after which number of clusters the total within sum of squares does not decrease much. And then at that point, we would select the optimal number of clusters. Let's say here, after 3 or 4 clusters, then the total within sum of squares does not decrease as much as before. So that would be the first method. Or we could try it with the average silhouette width method. Here we see that the optimal number of clusters according to this method would be 3. The rule would be to select the number of clusters that maximize this metric. And if we try the gap statistic, then we are going to see this chart, and then we will try to select that value for k that maximizes the gap statistic. In this case, this is telling us that the best value for k would be 1. So you would choose the method that you think it makes more sense for your data. Let's say here we can work with the silhouette method, and we would define 3 as the best value for k. Then we could analyze a cluster by plot. So we can create a cluster by plot in R with the fbs underscore cluster function. We would enter the k-means function with the desired number of k. And then if we run this, we get the by plot. So here you can note in the axis that we have the first principal component in the x-axis and the second principal component in the y-axis. The number in parentheses would be the amount of variability that is explained by each of the components. So here we can see how these clusters are well separated. So we have first cluster in color red here, then we have the second cluster in green, and the third cluster in blue. If we change the number of clusters to 4, let's see how this cluster plot looks like. For example, here we would see that clusters 2 and cluster 4 overlap. So let's say that we would prefer to work with 3 clusters. Okay, after that, instead of using the principal components as variable for the axis, we could create a similar plot using the original variables. Let's say, for example, I want to see how the clusters look like when comparing rating and price variables. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to save these results from the k-means clustering into an object called clusters, and then I'm going to extract the cluster vector, and then I'm going to assign it to a new column called cluster in the wine dataset. So okay, let's do that. So now here in the wine dataset we have a new column with the corresponding cluster for each of the observations. So we could create now a scatter plot, and then we can plot the rating variable in the x-axis, the price variable in the y-axis, and then we could color the points, the observations, based on the cluster column. And we define the geom underscore point function to create a scatter plot. So let's run this code. Now we can see then the observations based on these two variables, and the color is given by the cluster. So we can see that observations that have a higher rating and a higher price, they have been assigned mostly to cluster 1, while observations that have a lower values for rating and lower price, they have been assigned mostly to the cluster 3. Okay, that's it for this video about k-means clustering. Hope you like it. Thanks for watching. I'm going to leave a link in the description if you want to get access to the dataset and the scripts for you to practice. See you in the next video.